أناجي الحق في ليل بهيم أصدق النجوى، وأدعو الله من قلب سليم يطلب التقوى. أناجي الحق في ليل بهيم أصدق النجوى، وأدعو الله من قلب سليم يطلب التقوى.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum, and welcome to another special edition of Perspective. My name is Faisal Patel. I've just got back from Malawi. I went to cover the flood relief that's taken place there. The country has been devastated by raging rain, raging water, raging floods, whatever you want to call it. It was an absolute disaster. Now the Jamiatul Ulama South Africa and the Manolo Islamic Educational Trust, in conjunction with the Asian Muslim Relief Aid, or AMRA, has distributed more than 10,000 relief aid packs, weighing approximately, listen to this, 240 tons over 4 days to victims of the devastating Malawi floods. Heavy rains and flooding a few weeks ago caused a third of the country to be declared a disaster zone by Malawian President Peter Mutharika. With generous contributions from the South African community and the community of Malawi, Jamiatul Ulama South Africa, Namanolo Islamic Educational Trust and AMRA distributed the aid which would empower Malawians and hopefully get them back on their feet soon, along with your du'as as well, inshallah. Now, Jamiatul Ulama South Africa has urged South Africans to continue donating aid to Malawi to alleviate the destruction caused by these heavy rains and flooding in recent weeks. Just to go on from there, most Malawian people based in villages grow their own crops to meet their food requirements. It's these areas which were the worst hit by the floods, posing a critical problem. Now, some of the pictures will appear on screen, which I have taken. I've taken some video footage as well, so it will give you more or less an idea of what actually the area looked like. We didn't go into the deeper areas where there were more severe flooding, but obviously the time constraints didn't allow us to do that. But the little that we have taken will give you an idea, the viewer an idea of what these people are actually going through. Now, also to give us more perspective, more insight into the five-day mission in Malawi, our Amir Sub from the mission, Maulana Siddiq Bam, is in studio with us, and he's going to give us more insight on the day's activities. Assalamu alaikum, Maulana, and welcome to Perspective.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Nice having me here.
Maulana, I can see that me and you are both looking for words of where I'm red. You've got a little bit color as well. The trip was good, alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah, all things went well. Alhamdulillah, shukr. With the permission of Allah, all that we set out to achieve, inshallah, went well. The distribution went according to plan. And hopefully, inshallah, Allah accepts all the efforts rendered by everybody that was involved with this distribution.
Okay. Like I mentioned in the opening remarks to the program, that 10,000 packs were distributed over 4 days, 240 tons. I was there along with you. These packs were plus minus 25, 30 Ks, given along with a bucket and a dish, and also some cash, 4,000 kwacha, which equates to about 100 rand. But in these packs, obviously there were certain essential items that would assist the Malawian people to get back on the feet. Maybe you can explain to our listeners what was in these packs.
Just to break it down for you, these packs, together with the people at AMRA, they facilitated a lot in aiding to the packs what would be vital. Mm-hmm. And when in the packs, it contained some food supplements like maize meal, which they're accustomed to, it's a staple diet, some sugar, 2 kilos, 4 kilos of sugar, some plastic utensils so that they could use, and plastic sheeting because the thatch roofs, yes, tend to leak. Mm-hmm. So they put that in there and included it in the pack so as to make it easier for those people that are rebuilding or trying to rebuild their homes.
And then obviously there was a dish also given out and a bucket. What will these be used for?
This dish, one is a dish, a plastic dish, quite deep. It can be used for bathing or washing stuff. and there's the plastic bucket that was given. And along with this plastic bucket, we put, there was biscuits that were given, and also oil. Mm. So 2 by 2 liters of oil and a couple of packets of biscuits were also put in there to make it a bit easier for them.
Now, one of the team members that were with us was Malana Ubaidullah Boja, and also the area that was affected with which we happened to be was Namanolo. There's a Darul Ulum that is currently in this village, and if you look at some of the pictures that that will be on screen, that the water level was as high as the brown mark on some of the buildings, and you can see the damage that was caused. Sure. Now, we, Malana Ubaidullah Boja, did speak to the chief of the Manolo village, so let us have a look at that footage, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We are in Namanolo, a place in Malawi. We have with us the chief of the clan at the moment. His name is Brother Ahmed, and he will be giving us some advices and showing us some of the appreciation he has with the pastoral distribution. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi. Brother Ahmed, would you like to share a few words with the listeners of ITV International today?
I am very much happy for this day. I greatly appreciate the people, the donor from South Africa, for this great aid, because of assisting my people here. Indeed, the problem was very, very great. The problem was very, very great, but because of this aid, my people's hearts are now calmed down. And because of that, I pray to the Almighty Allah that he must bless those the donors of this aid and also multiply their wealth. And also, they must be granted the Mujanna in the hereafter. On behalf of all the beneficiaries of this aid, I say so that I thank you very much.
I want to see you.
So as we've seen from the footage, that the chief is very appreciative of the work that is done by Jamiatul Ulama and Namanolo. But what has struck me most is about the damage caused. We spoke to a lady called Halima Nuri. I spoke to her, and she was saying that the water level was so high that people were running from their homes, and they were going and taking shelter into the masajids, shelter under trees. Maybe you can elaborate a little bit on that.
When we went to Namanolo, we found that the school, the entire roof of the school was blown off. So also with at the Darulum, at the hostel area, that we found also the roof to be blown off. And the water levels is quite evident. Mm. In fact, Molana Idris at Namanolo was telling us it's as high as the windowsills. Mm-hmm. And you can still see the puddles all over the mud. In certain areas, it's still not accessible. Mm-hmm. But Allah Ta'ala make it easy for them, inshallah, in that regard.
Now, I don't know if viewers were able to understand the devastation caused. While we were in Namanolo and Molana was distributing the packs, I happened to walk around in the particular village. There was a resident, the same Halima Nuri, 40 years old, who took me around in this village to show me the destruction it was caused. And I'm telling you, it was absolutely terrible. Pictures will never do justice. There was still standing water. It has receded, but entire homes were destroyed. Entire homes were destroyed, and in one instance, in her particular case, there were 11 people living in one room because their homes were destroyed. Now, also, there's a whole lot of other issues that come with people living in one room. There's the whole issue of privacy. You've got your son-in-law, your daughter-in-law, your children, your grandchildren living in one room. But also the problem of ablution, to take a bath, to go to toilet. This has all been destroyed by the particular floods. And if you look at it, it's absolutely heartbreaking. Now, look, speaking about the infrastructure in that particular area, it's also very, very far from where tarred roads are. Sometimes it used to take up to 45 minutes, Molana, to negotiate a road that was just 5 kilometers. Obviously, the specs that we have been distributing will make it easier, inshallah, for these people.
Inshallah, it will alleviate to some extent. This is what we're terming immediate relief to assist them for now. And later on, inshallah, we will discuss a little more on how to the long-term plan, medium to long-term plan, inshallah.
Just to digress from the whole issue of the distributing of the packs, we understand, and like I mentioned earlier, that these areas are deep into the villages. You have to drive very, very far. The roads are not tarred, they're muddy. They've been soaked, waterlogged rather. But I think the issue of the toilets has been concerning for me. I know I came through a couple of situations. But what we're going to do is we're going to discuss that after the break, inshallah. And then we'll give our listeners some of the lighter moments of actually distributing this aid. It was absolutely an experience that, you know, none of us, all six of us, will never forget. And for me, like I mentioned to Molana, is the problem of the toilets. That was just used to take its toll. But inshallah, after the break, we will continue with this conversation and give you more perspective, more info on our recent trip to Malawi to cover the floods that have devastated the country. Stay tuned to Perspective.
أصدق النجوى وأدعو الله من قلب سليم يطلب التقوى إلهي صرت في ظرف عصيب فاكشف البلوى فيا
Welcome back to Perspective. My name is Faisal Patel. We are speaking about my recent trip along with the Jamiatul Ulama South Africa and Namanolo Islamic Educational Trust, including the Asian Muslim Relief Aid, distributing much-needed aid to Malawi people. You can interact with me. Send me a mail on faisal@itvnetworks.tv. Drop me a tweet on FAZ143 or even comment on facebook.com/Faisal Patel. Now, before the break, when we were speaking about this toilets, I know I had to go seriously at certain times. And sometimes we take it for granted that here in South Africa we have all these amenities. Maybe some areas don't have, but not to sort of go on that issue. It's a separate issue altogether. Mm-hmm. But in these areas, I mean, the toilets they use are actually the long drops.
Sometimes it brings back some childhood memories to some people. Yeah. And unfortunately, you were our guinea pig in that whole situation. But yes, that's the way it is. Most of them do not have built-up homes. It's all made out of mud and straw.
Yes.
And when the water hits those particular buildings, they crumble very easily.
Absolutely.
Especially the amount of water that came through. Like I was telling you, in Namanolo itself, it's normally a very parched and dry area. And this time it was lush and green. It was because of the water that we had.
Absolutely. Now, if you see some of the footage and of the pictures we have, Malawi itself, besides the floods, is an absolutely beautiful country. Rolling hills, valleys, absolutely breathtaking. And I would recommend anybody going there for holiday. It is absolutely nice. Now, Molana, speaking about the heat, we know that you can see from our complexion, we've gone a shade darker. What was it like working in the heat? I think if I was speaking to one of the Amra guys at that one particular day at the Kalulu Stadium, if I'm not mistaken, where 2,000 packs were distributed, there was a 45-degree heat. How did you personally cope with that heat and obviously to replenish yourself with water and all that?
The heat was, subhanAllah, was amazing. It was very hot. It's quite evident. But I guess with Allah Ta'ala's help, and I think it's a small price to pay in assisting those people that really, they actually, according to one of the Amra members, is the bottom of the bottom of the food chain. So I don't think the heat really, but it was very hot, I won't lie. It was very hot. And also thanks to Brother Faisal, who is who was our Amir on that particular trip, for putting aircon, meaning he used to drop cold water in our backs to motivate us to continue further.
Yeah. Now, like I mentioned before, Molana was mentioning a point about the Kalulu Stadium, where over 2,000 packs, relief aid packs, were distributed to these people that are actually suffering. And what was amazing about this particular distribution point, and not to forget the others as well, this because it happened on the next day as well. When we gave out the specs, you must remember there's almost 2,000 people sitting in the stadium under intense heat into various villages. And they were singing the song. They were singing the song that totally mesmerized the entire team. And I don't understand, I think it's called Chichawa. I don't understand the language. And I got somebody to translate for me. And that's where Faisal came in, the Amir of the of that particular day, and said, listen to what they're saying. They are saying Islam is number one. And I happen to get a little bit of that footage. Let's have a look at it and see how appreciative these people are. As you can see, the determination, the appreciation, it is overwhelming. To see there while you're there, it reverberated across the entire place where we were. And this video footage that you've seen will not do justice. Now, Mulana, coming on to some of the stats of the whole mission, maybe you can give us some stats of what was distributed, what was it all about?
Coming to the stats, Faisal mentioned earlier on, approximately 10,000 packs were distributed, weighing close to 240 tons of aid that was delivered over those 4 days. May Allah Ta'ala accept again, once again. We had packs being distributed on the first day, that is the Thursday that we were there. Close to 300 packs were distributed in the Minama area. There were two teams made. And then we had another distribution that took place in Kimu. And there were about 250 packs distributed. The same team then went to Makawa. Mm-hmm. They worked very hard, I should say that, and acknowledge that. They did actually about three trips to get the distribution done. And there was about 750 packs that were distributed in that area. Then the next day we did Namanolo, where 450 packs were distributed, alhamdulillah. And thereafter we moved on to Ntaja, which for us was a bit big because we did the 750 all at once. That was in the Ntaja area. Mm-hmm. And then the Saturday, Sunday, we joined the Amra members. Alhamdulillah, we managed to distribute 3,000 packs on Saturday in the Chikwawa area district. And on Sunday, about 2,000 packs in the Ngabu area. So alhamdulillah, that's what the states were all about.
Now, some of the team members that were with us, I know them, but I'll leave it up to you just to say who were on the team of six that we went
to. The team members consisted of Brother Faisal Patel himself, alhamdulillah, our media man, and then Maulana Ubaidullah Boja, who also serves at the Lodium branch at the Jamiatul Ulama South Africa, along with Maulana Asad Pandor. He's in the welfare department at Jamiatul Ulama South Africa. And then we had Hafiz Adil Vaid, who from his own side sacrificed his business time and also joined us on that mission, along with Hafiz Nazir Ahmed Mia, who I should say was alhamdulillah a motivation for us to move forward, alhamdulillah. So those are the six that joined us, and including myself.
One of the incidents also I want to talk about, Maulana, and maybe we can explain to our viewers, is that when we used to drink bottled water, and we the water is we finished, we used to throw those bottles out. And these kids used to come swarming and get those bottles that were empty. I mean, what was the motivation behind all this?
Those bottles, subhanAllah, we take for granted and we dispose of it. These children, they collect these bottles and they sell them. They actually get a deposit on a plastic bottle. To them, it's some sort of income and sources them in terms of their food and stuff.
Now, speaking about that also, you know, also I was saying that these people went through so much. they lost their houses, they lost their homes. There was close to 270 people that died, almost a million homeless, right? How did they, you know, manage to muster up that smile? Every time we went to a village, they were smiling, they were cheering, they were laughing, they surrounded us, happy. Never a bother on their face, yet they suffered so much.
That was one salient point I think all the members took back, was the humility, their humility came into us. It had such an effect that when you looked at them, it was the effect, you can't explain.
No, you can't explain, of course.
But seeing them, and even sitting in that heat, Faisal, we were busy. So you felt it, but not that much. Imagine sitting there, and you're distributing 2,500 packs, and you're the person, 2,499, and you're waiting in that heat to come and take your bag, and yet you show appreciation.
Now, that's absolutely brilliant. Like Maulana explained, you know, it is, I cannot explain it. Words will never do justice. These people suffered. We've seen their suffering. And yet, I promise, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our efforts, but they were always smiling, never ever complaining. Yet they faced so much problems. Maulana, we just got a few minutes left. We understand from the Jamiat that this is an ongoing effort. Maulana Yusuf from Jamiat spoke to me. He says that you know, we should continue to urge our viewers, our listeners, people out there, to continue donating to the Malawi relief effort. Inshallah, the banking details will be on screen. So donate generously. Inshallah, the banking details will be on screen. Maulana, last 2 minutes, maybe you can just give your concluding remarks and comments.
I just would like to thank, firstly, Allah for selecting us and allowing us to be part of this whole distribution. May Allah Ta'ala accept your donations, accept the efforts of all the role players that were involved in this, accept the efforts, especially of Amra, who made it very, very easy for us, providing water, providing food for us to do during this distribution. But just, I hope you got time, I just want to mention the one thing that Brother Nazir mentioned to us, and he's the person from the horse's mouth, literally, who saved a woman who was up, who took refuge and shelter in a tree when the floods hit, with her 2-day-old baby. And they spent 4 days, this mother never ate consecutively for 4 days, just to protect her baby. And the only way they reached them was via helicopter. Which was, and he told me that the effects of that was long-lasting. But may Allah Ta'ala accept, and please donate generously. We want more lillah contributions, so that we got what we went for was immediate relief. We need something that will now sustain them between medium to long-term relief, looking to give them seeds, looking to, inshallah, rebuild their homes, and things like that, inshallah. Right.
Well, Jazakallah so much for coming in, and it was an absolute pleasure to be part of the team.
Jazakallah, it was fantastic.
Dave, you heard it from Maulana Siddiq Bam. He was part of the team, and I was part of their magnificent team that was in Malawi. And I know in Malawi they do have ITV, because I've spoken to people, they've watched this particular program of perspective. So if you're watching this evening, to you people, Jazakallah so much for taking care of us, showing us the place, and also being such great hosts of the team from South Africa. Remember that you can interact with me by sending me a mail at faisal@itvnetworks.tv. You can drop me a tweet at faizy143, or you can even comment on facebook.com/faisalpatel. Unfortunately, we have come to an end of this week's program. Join me again next week when we cover more stories that are making headlines in Malawi, like we spoke, or even locally or internationally. From myself, Faisal Patel, and the magnificent team here at ITV, fi amanillah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
أنادي الحق في ليل لهيم أصدق النجوى وأدعو الله من قلب سليم يطلب التقوى أنادي الحق في ليل لهيم أصدق النجوى وأدعو الله من قلب سليم يطلب التقوى إلهي صرت في ظرف عصيب فاكشف البلوى فيا ربي أنا عبد لرد الطيب